This is a presentation of WellThatSchool.com. Quickly taking over the world. This podcast is made possible by The Left Hand, handmade herbal skincare. You can find them on the internet at thelefthand.net. Also, The Pink Box Burlesque, Tuscaloosa's only burlesque troupe. Find them on the internet at www.pinkboxburlesque.com. And Bel Chev Artisan Goat Cheese, great cheese made from goat milk. You can find them on the internet at belchev.com.
Hi folks, this is TJ Ripp from thetowerofbammer.com. This will be a weekly diversion into the world of sports, but not just any sports, football. And not just any football, but college football. And not just college football, but Alabama football. Now, the reason is that this is a local show, and so we're going to focus on local sports. Now, this season's coming up, and this will be just sort of a season preview, looking at what to expect this year, the ins and outs, and hopefully it won't bore you to death here. All right, so this season, there seem to be two schools of thoughts going into Nick Saban's second season. There's these folks that seem to be thinking that it might be sort of a mediocre or average season, looking at around 7-4 record, or 7-5, or something like that. Then there's other folks who see this number one recruiting class, Saban's for second year, and they're seeing SEC championship, they're thinking BCS games. I'm somewhere in the middle there. But there's good reasons for both of these fans to think this. Mostly it's the schedule. And if you haven't looked at it yet, it's definitely huge amounts of ridiculous away games and then cupcake home games, excluding the Auburn game at the end of the season. And if you look at the schedule, we start off with Clemson at Atlanta, which is kind of a toss-up. But then we immediately go into two cupcakes with Tulane and Western Kentucky. But if you look at the away games, just solely based on that, we have to go to Baton Rouge to play LSU. We have to go to Fayetteville to play Arkansas. We have to go to Athens to play Georgia. It's just a monster schedule. And these teams are all like in the national picture. These are all like top 10 teams. So there's you know, definitely a reason to be a little hesitant. But if we steal one, you know, that's going to be great for us. Now the home schedule though. The home schedule is where it gets kind of depressing because I love going to these football games. I love, you know, the atmosphere and the crowds and just, you know, when a good school comes into town, it adds a lot of excitement in the air. This year is not so much. We get to start off with the green wave of Tulane. Then we get to next week, awesome, Western Kentucky comes into town. I mean, it's a horrible schedule. Then we get, you know, we play the Mississippis here, Mississippi State and Ole Miss. Then we get to play Arkansas State. Oh my, watch out. Then finally we wrap up the season with the Auburn game, the only game that any student has a chance of making any money on their tickets with. So if you're looking to, like, you know, cash in, just do it early, I guess. Cash in your entire season ticket run for, you know, at least $300 or $400. Otherwise, you're not gonna get, if the season goes to crap, I mean, you're not gonna get anything for this. But let's, you know, cross our fingers and hope not. Home schedule is so abysmal that I'm willing to do two things this season. I'm going to start ranking the home games on a bourbon of bladder system. Basically, how many bladders of bourbon should you bring into the stadium? But depending on how lame, boring, or, you know, exciting the game is going to be. For instance, first game of the year, Tulane, it's going to be a 3-bladder game. Go ahead and bring 3 bladders of bourbon. You know, finish 2 of those at least by halftime, and by the third, you know, get sauced. We should be up by double digits at that point, so don't worry about it. Now, games like Auburn or Mississippi State, for some god awful reason, they beat us 3 times in a row now. Or is it 2 years in a row or 3? 2. Yeah, 2. Anyway, we shouldn't be talking about that because there's no reason we should be worried about them, but we are. So those are going to be 1-bladder games. So just keep that in mind for the rest of the season, and I'll bring you up to date here. My other prediction, because this home schedule is so awful, and it's just so terrible, and just going to be just draining having to watch these things, I'm going to go ahead and predict we win every game at home this year, even the Auburn game. That's right. I'm predicting a straight sweep in Tuscaloosa this year. And I'm pretty confident about that. And as a matter of fact, our season actually kind of relies on that. We're not going to get any gimme games away from, you know, away from Tuscaloosa. So if we do what I think we'll do and win every game at home and then maybe steal the Arkansas game, which shouldn't be a steal. I mean, that Bob Petrino's first year, it's going to be a mess over there. We should take it to him pretty easily. And then maybe the Clemson game or the Tennessee game are the most likely candidates next. We should end up with around an 8-4 record, maybe a 9-3, which I think most fans would be happy with. Now, as far as SEC championships and BCS games, we're going to have to hold off on that for another week because I just don't see it right now. But I have some very interesting predictions for this Clemson game, and actually, you'll have to tune in next week to hear about that. This is TJ Ripp from Tower of Bama signing out, and roll tide. Better be practicing. Grandma, jamma, yellow hammer, give them hands.